I'm working on these Autodesk parts. There's two different parts. Titan had the idea to run them in double vices.
When approaching a setup like this, we have to really rely on all our experience, the years and years in this trade. Back in 2005, when I started my own company, I didn't have employees. So I really had to think about how to run these machines in a constant manner while I could be multitasking and doing multiple things.
Right here, I'm simulating the very first part, the first stop. 3/4 end mill is roughing, and then finishing 1/2-inch end mill is cutting that pocket out in the middle.
A lot of times when you run parts, you have one part, you go through all the tool changes, and you run that one part, you open the door, you exchange the part, you put it back in. If you have two parts or 100 parts, it grabs that tool and runs each particular part. So the more parts that you can run at once, you're saving all that time from going and grabbing those tools.
The two different parts and the first vices are getting profiled and cut. So the second side is super important. It's got this 3D ball track surface to get a super smooth, nice finish in there. This 3D surface where when the assembly goes together, it's gonna be calibrating the whole fixture.
So the plan here is to run both parts that are assembling together and run them at the same time.
So I'm working on the second part. Right here is ball tracking the top of that surface. Now I can flip it over, simulate the second side.
16 parts, two different jobs coming out at the same time. Complete, so we can make sure everything fits, form and function is perfect.
What's up, Alex?
What's up, Dan?
We got 500 of these things to run. You got your inspection stuff, your thread gauges. Start lining them up on the table.
We just made a couple fixtures, and it's gonna help us run these parts for Autodesk non-stop, where you can run 20 parts, 100 parts at a time, and just flips, and it just keeps going. I have to figure out how to run the parts as efficiently as possible and make it cheaper than somebody else. So each one slides in, then we take this Mighty Bite Pit Bull clamp, and I pop this guy right in on the inside. The second op, what we have here is we have another clamp. This guy actually drops down, and as the bolt goes straight down, it spreads, locking one part here, one part here. It's gonna rotate, and we'll just keep doing the same thing over and over. Instead of a part taking 6 minutes, it takes 50 seconds. Therefore, I can make good money, I can pay my employees, and just keep the ball rolling.
Just finished packaging up the aluminum parts for Autodesk. I'm gonna take them over to the platers. They're gonna get a black type 2 anodize on them, then Titan can deliver them down to the Bay Area.
So let me introduce you to Shalom. He's busy assembling the parts.
I hear you are the man.
Well, I got the parts right here.
So making it happen. Right, how did it look? Yeah.
Looks great, actually. Just now I'm putting them together to test that we've got a great fit.
Must have had some great designers.
I'll say, whoever designed and built this knew what they were doing.
So it fits, huh?
Oh, no, man, this sucks. The parts don't fit.
I just watched it. It looks like perfection to me.
No, man, it's totally perfect. It's ready to install on Ember Z-axis. We've got to have everything be super precise here because we're 3D printing down to 25 micron layers. Even we could go down to 10.
So 25 microns, like we deal with 0.001, 1,000ths,
well
20%
that.
Yeah,
we're well below that.
Awesome.
We can go even further down to 10 microns, or that would be a fraction of a thou.
Very, very fine.
Very fine, yeah, that's
awesome.
That's the best I can put it, yeah. Snug the calibration bolt, and we are off to the races.
3D printing is so amazing to me. I thought there was like maybe one or two styles, so this is a whole nother style, completely different than anything I've ever seen.
So with this, we're actually printing with UV light and photosensitive resin. You see the light under there? That's actually transforming the liquid resin on that layer into a solid and then repeating. So we're really excited about what we're creating and also about putting it out in the wild and seeing what other people are gonna do as well.
These parts were just on the machines, and they're right there.
And now there they are, working away, printing like mad at down to 25 micron layers. So we got super precision here.
Awesome.
I shake your hand, but I got resin all
we'll
over
do a fist
me.
Bump.
So all right, there we go. That's
boom.
Good.
Boom.
All right. Thanks, Titan.
All right.
Yeah, see right on.